the other half with fire planes. It's supposed to be a small event, but there was some tall guys flying fire planes also. They went over the same thing. They did active combat. The goal of both groups was to be able to come back to this country and fly commercial. And we were very, very, very disappointed that, you know, after you get to be a fighter, and you can fly in any kind of weather, any kind of aircraft, and anywhere in the world, and you come home and you're not able to get a job doing what you are best qualified to do, that is disappointing beyond belief. And I'm happy today because I've lived long enough to see a change. We have quite a few, I won't give a number, black commercial pilots, and I have been able to meet at least 3 black women commercial pilots. So that's what I'm happy to be able to sit here and tell you about.
Could I ask you a question? I sat in on the national meeting last night, and this is one of the questions that everybody was asking all of the United States. And the answer that they asked us to give was that there was just a little under 1,000 people who are part of the Tuskegee experience. That means not only the pilots, but the support group, the nurses, and everybody that considers to the Tuskegee Airmen. That is why, if you look at the room numbers that generally have around their necks, which is a replica of the congressional medal, you will see that there are more than one person represented on the planes or on the back. As for knowing how many are still living, we don't, because they're dying every day. They talked about 4 that passed away.